cooking for you today a special pasta which has been in my menu in Cyma for the past 14 years. Start the recipe by heating your pan. We have generous amounts of extra virgin olive oil. We start off with putting some garlic. Alright. What I usually do from the start is I put some sea salt. You're gonna have a very garlicky flavored olive oil. We're gonna put some bokovo or chili flakes. Some tomato. Then you wanna drop the pasta in boiling water. Then you wanna put some green onions. And then you add some of the arugula stems, right? And then some fresh parsley, right? So it has that bitter taste, right? Season it with salt, that's the ground pepper. You can turn the heat at this point. We want to get some of the pasta water. Gonna happen is you're gonna be emulsifying that sauce later. Okay. See that? That's already your sauce bubbling. So the pasta is al dente. It's slightly underpassed. So what we need to do is the sauce should reduce even more. Don't be afraid of putting pasta water because you need the pasta to absorb all of that, okay? You toss it, reduce the sauce, and then, right, when you think that the sauce is almost gone, you put the Parmigiano, Reggiano, and this one I'm using 18 months. So, what's gonna happen? It's just gonna emulsify with your sauce. It has to give you that sound. Can you hear it? So, we're ready to plate. A bit more Parmesan. Put some fresh arugula on top. Extra virgin olive oil. Cyma's Roka pasta. So, we're gonna be making quinoa salata. We're gonna be starting off with making our dressing. We start off with garlic, then some shallots, some red wine vinegar, lemon juice, coarse grain Dijon mustard. And this is honey. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna blend this. Not too much, just a gentle blend, okay? So, you add your extra virgin olive oil. Now, you put some parsley. Some dried oregano because it's again Greek, and then some salt and then some pepper. Now to assemble the salad, we need some fresh arugula. Now this one is called lolo verde. Right? You just tear it apart. You wanna put some quinoa. Toss it. Then you put some dressing. It may take about a minute or two just to make sure that you're tossing the dressing. You're coating each leaf and each grain of quinoa. Making sure also that you do not over dress or coat the too much, because it's gonna be too heavy, too dense. Then you wanna put some of the quinoa. You wanna do some pine nuts. This is toasted pine nuts. Some sultanas. And then you wanna top it with, this is grated walnuts. Then you wanna top it with shaved kefalo graviera. This is a Greek cheese, but you can really actually use just Pecorino Romano or Parmigiano Reggiano. What you wanna do is you wanna drizzle a bit with extra virgin olive oil. And then there you go. That's Souv by Cyma's Quinoa Salata. Oh, you guys miss Green Pastures, so I'm sharing my recipe today. The recipe that I'm sharing today is our very popular Green Pastures style of carbonara. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be slicing our salt pork, right? Our salt pork, as you can see, it doesn't have that salitre hue, right? And what you wanna do is you wanna cut it into cubes, such, right? Then we're gonna be browning this. Okay. Well, as we wait for it to brown, right, we're gonna chop up some fresh mushrooms. I like using this variety of mushrooms because number one, it's locally grown. This tastes a little lighter than a chanterelle. This is what we call oyster mushroom. They're gonna shrink, so I suggest you slice them into big pieces. Salt pork, or bacon, or you can use pancetta. What's important is the fat that goes in there, right? Once you have the toasted bacon, you just add your mushrooms. Right? Add your mushrooms. Make sure that you saute them. Right? You need to salt the water, so put some sea salt. Right? And then put some pasta. Okay? You can add a little olive oil, right? At this point you can season it with salt and pepper. Season with salt. Fresh ground pepper. Put some green peas. Olive oil. What I like doing here is I want to put this in a mixing bowl. Okay. Now I crack fresh eggs. And then I put an egg yolk. Grated pecorino. And grated parmigiano. Some pepper. Mix them all together. Right. Put them all. So we're just waiting for the pasta. It's done. Point. It has to be timing. So get the pasta. Right. Then you drop it on the oven. Drop it. And the heat of the pasta should cook the eggs, right? So you want to get also, you want to get some pasta water. So it has to give you that sound. You know it's cooking, right? The plate, right? Put some Parmigiano underneath. Right. Then get your pasta. And then put some more pasta and then put the sauce. And the mushrooms and put some more Parmigiano on top, and then I'm like garnishing it with some fresh flat leaf parsley. To balance everything. Some pepper. A little bit more. This is actually paprika oil, just to give it a little bit of color. That's our version of the carbonara.